your password probably sucks, but that's not the real problem here. The real problem is the companies that store it like amateurs, making even stronger passwords crack in seconds sometimes. Key stretching changes this equation by making every wrong guess cost actual money in electricity and hardware and time. Picture your password as a cheap lock on a storage unit, for example. Anyone with bolt cutters can walk right through it, essentially. Key stretching wraps that lock in layers of computational concrete. Suddenly, those bolt cutters need to become like industrial mining equipment that burns thousands of dollars in electricity just to try to get it open. And most people think password strength comes from randomness and length, and that's part of it, but there's more to it. What actually matters is how expensive your password becomes to guess. For example, a 8-character password properly stretched with modern algorithms resists attacks better than a 16-character password stored with basic protection. And here's what nobody actually explains about password storage. When you create an account, the website doesn't actually save your password, right? They run it through a mathematical function that creates a unique fingerprint called a hash. Attackers who steal these hashes need to try to guess the passwords and check if they can create the same type of fingerprint that was created. Now, without key stretching, modern graphics cards check billions of guesses per second. So your super secure 123 password falls in basically microseconds. With proper stretching using something like Argon 2, each guess takes half a second and eats a gigabyte of RAM. Now, your attacker went from billions of attempts per second down to maybe one or two. The math becomes kind of hilarious when you scale it up. So testing 1 million password candidates at 2 guesses per second requires almost 6 days of continuous computation, which is a lot more effort, right? Obviously, testing 1 billion, though, requires nearly 16 years. And that assumes perfect efficiency with zero downtime, like no hardware failures, no electrical costs piling up. So think about what that actually means for mass surveillance, for example. The NSA can't just vacuum up everyone's data and crack it later when key stretching is actually done right. They need to try to decide if cracking your encrypted file is worth burning 50 grand in computational resources. And most people really aren't worth that level of investment. Now, early Unix engineers basically understood this principle back when computers filled entire rooms because they had to, right? Like, you have to be more efficient when you have less. So they used multiple rounds of encryption, DES specifically, not to hide passwords better, but to make each guess hurt. And modern algorithms took this concept and basically weaponized it into economic warfare against attackers. PBKDF2 runs your password through thousands or even millions of hash iterations, and each feeding into the next, kind of like a computational chain that can't be shortcut. Bcrypt uses something called blowfish cipher to create deliberate complexity that really neutralizes GPU advantages to a large degree. Those expensive graphics cards that hackers love suddenly become inefficient paperweights, basically, or space heaters. Xcrypt goes nuclear on memory requirements by demanding huge amounts of RAM for each guess. And it makes specialized cracking hardware just economically stupid. Your attacker needs actual computers with real memory, not just raw processing power. Argon 2 combines all of these approaches with adjustable parameters that let defenders adapt to evolving threats when they evolve. Have you heard of key stretching before this video? Like, most people haven't, and that's why I'm asking. Because companies really, in one degree, don't really want you to understand how badly they're failing you. I'd definitely like to hear in the comments if this is new information to you. I'm genuinely curious how well this knowledge is actually spread outside of the kind of technical circles that exist. And here's where companies, to some degree, constantly screw you over. Like, your bank probably protects your password worse than a properly configured WordPress blog does. They chose speed, like, over security because they'd rather get hacked than wait an extra half a second. And that's just incompetence of the really. The implementation failures definitely go even further than just being cheap, though. We can't just put it all on that. Key stretching needs something called the salt. And basically, it's a random value unique to each user that gets mixed with your password before it gets stretched. And without proper salts, attackers can basically pre-compute answers or optimize their approach. Yet company after company reuses salts or doesn't use them at all because their developers learned security from a YouTube tutorial that was not this channel. Password managers like KeePass and Bitwarden do actually implement this correctly for things like their master password. bcrypt is great in that it lets you configure millions of iterations for disk encryption. Even some consumer routers actually support stretched passwords if you dig through their settings. The tools exist, companies just really refuse to actually use them properly. And here's the kind of dark comedy of our surveillance state. The FBI complains about going dark when criminals use encryption, but what that actually means is that properly stretched keys cost too much to actually crack. Actual security interferes with their dragnet surveillance program, and every additional iteration of key stretching represents friction against the unconstitutional spying that's constantly going on. The same government that's spending billions on quantum computers to break encryption can be defeated by properly configured password stretching that any competent developer could implement in an afternoon. They're building Death Stars while we're winning with computational guerrilla warfare. Your operational security depends on understanding these kind of basic dynamics that exist. Strong passwords alone will not protect you when they're stored completely incorrectly. But even mediocre passwords become nearly unbreakable when properly stretched. The transformation happens through pure mathematics. And that means, like, there's no backdoors or weaknesses. It's just computational expertise that scales with attacker resources, right? Like, individual users can take control immediately. When choosing services, ask about their key stretching parameters. Use tools that let you control these settings. Make your secrets too expensive for anyone to try and steal. Stop trusting companies that have proven repeatedly that they choose profit over your protection. The economics become pretty brutal for attackers when we get to scale, right? Like cryptocurrency miners, for example, perfectly understand this. They calculate electricity costs versus potential profits. Password cracking follows identical economics. Make the cost exceed the value and the attack stops. And not because attackers can't actually succeed, that's not what I'm saying, but because they just can't afford to succeed. Like, surveillance capitalism depends on weak security to remain profitable. Data breaches need to stay cheap. If every password required serious computational investments to actually crack, the entire ecosystem of buying and selling stolen credentials to some degree would collapse. And that's exactly why proper implementation faces such strong resistance. Every properly protected password increases the global cost of surveillance. Every company implementing real key stretching makes mass data breaches less and less valuable, right? Like, the aggregate effect could absolutely cripple the surveillance economy if deployed widely enough. And this isn't really, this has nothing to do with, like, personal privacy, right? I'm talking more about like systemic resistance to authoritarian overreach. For example, like, key stretching transforms authentication from a speed bump into kind of an economic battlefield where defenders set the terms, and you get to decide the computational requirements that will be needed. You control the memory demands. You force attackers to fight where their advantages essentially evaporate, and their budgets scream in pain. The solution is not that complex. New systems should use Argon 2 with at least 64 megabytes of memory with multiple iterations. Legacy systems need scrypt or bcrypt with aggressive parameters. Never accept PBKDF2 with SHA-1, despite what outdated compliance frameworks actually suggest. These definitely are not recommendations. They're kind of minimal, viable security in this day and age, right? With like $8 per hour criminals renting massive GPU clusters. What password managers or encryption tools are you using that actually implement proper key stretching? It's security theater to most companies. They don't bother actually doing this, which is why I saw making this video as a worthwhile project for us to sit down and discuss key stretching. If you haven't heard of this, I'd love to know about it in the comments. And if you did hear about it, I'd like to know what you know about it. And if you did know about it, I'm sorry that you already knew about it and saw nothing new. I get comments all the time where it's like, I already knew about this. Why didn't you talk about something more detailed and in depth? Sorry. I get a poll of what everyone knows when I make these videos. In any case, I digress. Thank you for watching to the end, and I'll see you in the next video.